It's sometime now that flat earthers are trying to explain ships or building disappearing bottom up at a distance using their magical perspective. The most exotic explanations have been presented, involving even more exotic terms like optical slant, line of convergence, disappearance rate, compressed visual field, angle of attack, expanded field of view, angular resolution limit, and whatever they can come up with. Of course, all of these explanations are dead wrong. However, Anthony Reilly, aka Sleeping Warrior, managed to have one thing right this time, for a change. In a reaction to a thread on his video, Physics Teacher misrepresents angular resolution and deceives his own audience, he states, "If a house brick can be seen 100 meters away, and also at 300 meters, and also at 500 meters, after a mile it cannot be seen. Let's say 3 miles, so there's no doubt. A house brick 3 miles away cannot be seen. Too small. If you want a few more, let's say 20 miles, you cannot see a house brick at 20 miles. I'm sure we can agree. Now put 30 stories on top of that brick and you can see the building, but you still cannot see the bottom of the tower." Ah, that's a pity. At the very end he goes wrong, as he usually does. He should have said, "But still, you cannot distinguish one brick from another." But he doesn't, and he does that on purpose. Reilly thinks that he is better at semantics than everybody else, but in fact his tricks are so transparent and obvious that even a three-year-old can see what he is doing here. But it gets worse. He adds, as if he knows his stuff, "This is called the Reilly criterion." And there he is wrong again. You see, everybody knows that due to perspective an object gets smaller the further away it is. At a certain distance it gets so small that your eyes cannot resolve it anymore. That is, that your eyes cannot distinguish the top of the object from the bottom. So the object merges into a single line. It is generally accepted that the angular size at which this phenomenon occurs for a person with normal vision is around 0.028 degrees, that is slightly more than 1.5 arc minutes. In optimum circumstances, this resolution limit can be set at 0.01145 degrees, that is slightly less than 1 arc minute. However, the Reilly criterion for diffraction limited vision for the human eye with an iris diameter of 5 mm and at a wavelength of 500 nanometer is 0.00699 degrees, that is less than 0.5 arc minute. So you not being able to see the house brick at a certain distance happens at a smaller distance than it would happen due to the Reilly criterion. It happens due to the limited resolution of your eyes. So the phenomenon that you cannot see the house brick is not caused by the Reilly criterion. But then there is some wise guy, this time it is Viet Voy, that answers with, "A brick at the bottom of the wall has the same size as a brick on top of the wall. They are both too small to be seen." Let's first examine how this works. I created a wall in a spreadsheet. It is 45 bricks high, and I calculated the angular size of each brick, which is 6 centimeters high, as seen at an observer height of 1.2 meter. And what do you see? The angular size of the higher bricks is smaller than the angular size of the lower bricks. So if we follow the reasoning of Riley, we shouldn't be able to see the top brick at a smaller distance than at the distance at which we cannot see the bottom brick anymore. As a side note, you see that the bottom brick has an angular resolution of 0.028 degrees, the resolution limit of a normal eye, at just 120 meters. The angular resolution of 0.00699 degrees, the Rayleigh criterion, is reached at just over 490 meters. So Riley is, at this point, wrong by a factor of at least 4. But the problem Viet Foy presents here is even worse for Riley. Sleeping Warrior cannot deny the fact that both top brick and bottom brick disappear at around the same distance. So he chooses the flight forward. Instead of admitting that his argument has fallen apart, he states that Viet Foy is beginning to get it. He just starts to add a new effect, compression. For whatever reason, an optical, not actual, compression at the bottom is always observed at the horizon. Again, it's to do with the angle. Might be the absolute cause, it might be correlative, but boats, buildings, mountains, anything at the horizon, be it on the ground or in the air, and heading towards the horizon from above, these things compress. But it gets even worse. Both Viet Foy and Kim Priapus's garden provide references to pictures and ask, where is the compression? So Riley stacks some other explanations to his growing pile of BS. Perfect example of an optical effect mixed with an actual effect. Towering, stretching, and an incoming tide explains that perfectly. To make things even worse, he also adds that there is an obstruction in the smaller angle caused just by the angle. He refers to this picture where someone argues that the angle between the viewing angle of the observer and the line of sight to the bottom of the object plays a role here. This, of course, is BS too also. Further away from the observer, this angle doesn't become smaller, it becomes greater. This can be easily demonstrated. When someone else, Revo this time, questions whether incoming tide could explain all of this, Riley changes his story once again. Of course it can. A Fata Brumosa mirage would explain it optically, and an incoming tide would explain it practically. And he closes off with this classic, water doesn't curve. It wouldn't be called level if it did. It would be called water curve. Thus, diverting from the problem at hand with a standard meme for flurfers to be used when you have painted yourself in a corner. And that is Anthony Riley, aka Sleeping Warrior, in the core. He starts off with, it always is the Rayleigh criterion. When that doesn't work, he adds to it that compression always is present. When pictures are shown where there is a bottom missing without any visible compression, it all of a sudden is also towering and incoming tide. And when that doesn't work, he ends with, and of course, there is the Fata Brumosa. But at the end of the day, in fact, the only thing he can say that might look as if he was right is,
it could be unicorn farts, it could be unicorn farts, it could be unicorn farts. Don't know what that means, it's just a number. It could be unicorn farts, it's just...